number six, December 16th. I'm Casey.
And I'm Dara.
I'm going to start with, I'm exhausted. Mom and I were up till 2:30 this morning wrapping presents. You don't realize how old you are until you get on the floor, tile floor, and wrap presents till 2 o'clock in the morning. I'm tired.
Me too.
And I have bags under my eyes. I could go to Hawaii on these bags. Okay, so let's get down to business. So last week, we had a couple questions come in. First one, people were asking about the cookie recipes. We will go ahead and link some cookie recipes below, but I'm going to be honest, I just Pinterest what I was wanting to eat.
Not me. Mine are the old-fashioned Good Housekeeping book back in the day. I think it was my grandma's recipe back in the day for the peanut butter cookies.
I'll see if I can find that recipe because I actually have her cookbook. If I can't, we'll post it. Next thing, we got a question if Nanny and Papa will come and do some guest appearance. So, I'm not sure that we can get my grandma on film again. However, I'm pretty sure I can convince my grandpa to come out here.
Oh, yeah.
But I did want to put a shout out there. On the 13th, they celebrated 60 years of marriage. 60 years. I'm going to go ahead and post a picture of them right here. This picture was taken quite a few years back, right before my grandpa retired, and it's one of my favorites.
And he retired at 55, so he's 81 now.
Yep.
It's been a while.
Definitely been a while. Okay, so then also wanted to mention the Real Housewives of Cross-Stitch, they made their 10,000. So awesome if any of you guys went over there and subscribed, they hit 10,000. So, for their giveaway, they have a question. What are two things you're thankful for? Go ahead and give us your two.
Well, I am thankful that I have my family. I have parents, my kids, very successful kids, and my grandkids.
I am thankful for my family as well. And I'm also thankful for my kids' teachers. All teachers out there, because anybody who can spend 8 hours with, you know, kids my kids'
with
age.
Her kids.
Not so much my kids. However, 30 of them. That's a big deal. So I am very thankful for teachers, and I'm very thankful that they get to take the 2 weeks off at Christmas with the kids. Go ahead.
And I'm thankful that my grandkids, they still love me. I went this week with my little guy, Troy. He invited me to go with him to the Nutcracker, and we had a great time at the Nutcracker. After the first act, he goes, "Are we done, Moy? I'm ready to go." So ballet might not be his thing, but I'm glad that my grandkids still like to do with their grandma or their moi.
Okay, next thing, those were our two answered questions. And then it says you have to subscribe, like, and then put which one of their patterns you want. They're doing 10 giveaways. So go on over to the Real Housewives of Cross Stitch and enter their giveaway.
You have to like them and you have to subscribe.
Next, I'd like to discuss with you guys the giveaway that we did a couple weeks back. We had bought Paula Lima's unicorn. Let me tell you about that unicorn. So I get it in the mail, all jazzed because I got it in the mail. I'm not a cross stitcher, you know, I'm just started out not too long ago. So I get it, it seems right. However, I told Mom, I'm gonna open it up and look at it, you know, maybe it's not that hard. I opened it up and there was nothing in the package. Yes, you heard that right. There was no chart in the package. So I reached out to the company that I bought it from. Super sweet girls. Apparently they had lost their mother and they were just getting rid of some of the things that was in her shop. And she must have used this pattern as a shop model and taken the charts out. So I explained my situation and how I needed that pattern. And they nicely got me another one right in the mail, maybe 2 days later. So Paula, we did ship your item. It's just a couple days later than the last video. Okay, next I'd like to talk about the Addicted Sisters and how jealous we are.
They went to Picture This Plus.
Apparently, that's a big deal. Tell me, what is Picture Me Plus? Picture
No, This Plus. It's a place that hand dyes all the kinds of Zweigart, any even weaves, linens. It's where I get all my material from.
Then also, Gloria Fagan, F-A-G-A-N. has asked that we do a bow tutorial. So we are going to go ahead and add it to this video.
So what you do first is you get your ribbon. I use 2.5 inch wide ribbon, and you measure out a piece that's from the longest point to the longest point is 23 inches long. And then what I do is I cut it at an angle. And
I feel like Vanna.
So you have, and it looks like this. I fold it in half.
Points together?
Yeah.
Okay.
Points together. And then I fold it in half again.
So I've got it in half now.
Fold it in half again to so where your point goes at the end and in half.
Okay, hold on. Let me show you guys what I got going on here. So she's folded in half so that the half meets the corner. Okay.
And then what I do is I take the first point.
So we unfold it and we take the center.
And then you put where you folded it and you line those two points up to the center.
Okay, so you take your center and your next fold and fold them together. Yes?
Yes. Put them, you line the folds up.
Okay, so now we've got something that looks more like a 3/4 fold.
And so then I pulled this part down just to kind of get it out of my way. And then I take the other corner, and here's my fold, and I line that up with the other fold.
Okay, so stop.
Yep.
Okay, so
and then
this is what, sorry guys, this is what we're doing. So here's your where your fold's at, and I've pulled the thing out of the way, okay?
And then you take this fold here.
Take that fold to the middle?
Yeah, you take that fold to the middle, and you line the fold to the center. So it kind of looks like this.
So your second fold, you're doing the same motion you just did on the first one.
Line the top and the bottom up.
So we're lining them up.
And then I just scrunch them together in the center to where
scrunching it together.
You have it like this.
And we're still leaving this thing up in the air.
Yep.
Okay, and so you get it scrunched.
And then?
Once you get it scrunched is when you start moving things.
Then?
Right?
Yep.
Okay.
Then, oops. You take your
pipe cleaner,
and I start it like right about there.
So like 2 inches
out? And then just wrap it.
Okay, so about 1.5, 2 inches on the top of it with the longer end underneath.
To me, that's like 3 inches.
That's only 3 inches.
Okay.
Okay, a shorter piece on top of your bow.
Yeah.
And the longer piece is the one you use for wrapping. Keep it tight.
And then you wrap it.
How many wraps? Two? Three?
I did 3 or 4 because you have a lot of the extra.
And this what? Okay.
So then take it to the back where your...
The ugly side of the bow.
Where the wing is.
Okay.
So this is what it looks like.
Okay.
You take your point, pull it down, take this point, line it up with the other one, give it a little tug, and then... You
fluff
your bow.
Zhuzh.
Yeah, that's it.
You zhuzh your bow.
So, anyway.
Give it a little fluffy.
And that's it.
Okay, so then, but I have a question. On the back, I still have two. Do I need to turn it?
Twist it together.
Okay, so on the back, you have like openings?
They're open.
So, go ahead and give it a twist, because that will give it like a two
turns.
And it
locks it in place.
It'll lock it in place. And then that way, you have it closed.
And so when you go to put it on your tree, if this is your tree, you just do that. And then you twist tie it like you do on
twist ties
a bread. And then that's it.
Okay.
So and then pull your little things down. And that's it.
I think it didn't come out half bad. Hey, hey, I can be taught. So here's so, the mom's sample. Here we are.
So...
Quick and easy.
Yeah. And for no more than $10, you can get, I think I'll be able to get maybe 75 bows out of this.
Inexpensive bows.
That's it.
So let's move on. Do you have any FFOs?
No.
FOs?
No.
Okay. How about some whips?
I have whips.
Okay. So let's start with a very special whip.
Yeah.
She's actually coming around the camera right now. Come get between Moy and I. This is my youngest daughter. Her name is Dion.
And she dressed up for us.
She dressed up for this video today. Can you say hi, Dion?
Hi.
So Dion has been working on her D. She completed her D. Oh, I guess I put something behind it. And she's starting the next row. She wants to do the whole heart in pink. And then what are you going to do on the outside?
The outside just black.
All black? All right. Can you say hi to everyone?
Hi.
Can you tell them to have a good day?
Have a good day.
Thank God you guys cannot smell how much perfume she has on.
She thinks it's smell-o-vision.
Now we're going to move on to our whips. What do you have, Mom?
Well, it's Christmas, so...
It is.
How did we know that?
Right? Oh, this one has beads.
So, yes.
The Sweetheart Tree by Sandra Cox Vonnestahl?
Sure.
Okay.
That's the back. You might want to turn it around. The N-O-L. Noel. So that they don't think maybe
here.
It's elf. Okay. So, here's the... This is how much I've gotten done.
All right. And now how do you add the diamond or the beads to it?
You do that separate.
But you stitch it in after?
You stitch it in later.
All right. What kind of material is this?
That's a linen of some sort, whatever the called for linen.
Okay. I don't know how many of you guys like to stitch on linen, but I think that linen is the devil. I'm just saying. It looks gorgeous when it's done, and I love the tiny stitches, but we'll talk about my experience with linen in just a moment.
And then my next one,
this is the sow that you're doing with Lisa and Terry?
Yes.
Okay.
Let Freedom Ring.
So here it is. We've showed you guys this one a couple times now. She's made a little bit of progress. This is the one I was telling you about last week, and then the birds interrupted. She had called me and was all upset because she had to remove two rows because it was two stitches off, but it's 12 pages long?
15
pages long. So with those two rows off, that would throw the whole thing off. Well, you guys understand. So she was pretty upset. So here she is starting to work on the flag. All right. And what is it on? Because that feels like a linen too.
It's on Picture This Plus Dublin.
Dublin.
32 count.
Okay.
And then next is my...
Oh,
January, I found it.
The Wordplay by Brenda Gervais. You've gotten quite a bit done on this one.
I did.
There is a good possibility you will be done in January.
I will be done in January.
So here it is. Oh, there we go.
That's all my whips.
Okay. All right, so I have one whip. Like I was telling you guys last week, I jumped on the wagon with Steph, and I started working on the hands-on design your celebration, but I am going to do a different colorway. I've picked out more pinks, teals, lavenders. It's just more my colors than the oranges and greens. So this is where I'm going to talk about the linen. I got this linen at the Stitch
and
Frog.
I did tell her, don't go with linen. And she goes, okay, Mom.
Okay. She said, don't go with linen. Yes. However, this is Zweigart. She did not say, don't go with Zweigart. And for us newbies, I didn't know that Zweigart is linen or a form of. So I bought it because I wanted the polka dots. So anyone who has worked with Zweigart, they're not even little squares at all. There's some tiny ones, there's some thick ones. And then I'm not even sure when the dots got put in, it seems like it made the holes bigger in some spots. It's something. I mean, I'm doing it, and I'm going to use this fabric because I really like it, but not the business for a newbie. But that's where I'm at.
And then, So I got her...
Oh, the needles.
Yes.
You want to get them out real quick? So, in the midst of using the Zweigart... Am I saying that right? Zweigart?
Zweigart.
Okay. A regular needle just wasn't working. Then I went and got the sharper ones. You gotta like pick the little lines so that the stitches go and they don't look even. I don't like that. However, Mom got me these. the Easy Guide Needle. Needles with a ball point. Size 28, 5 in a pack. Tell us about these, Mom.
What they do is they just separate the threads and they glide right through. And it makes so much easier to do linen with these type of needles. They have little balls on the end of them. Oh, I got them off of Etsy.
She got them at the Easy Guide Needle. So I'll go ahead and post a link to her Etsy shop. She just gave them to me, so I'm going to try them. And I will give you guys a product review next week for a newbie. Okay? I guess I'm still working on Liberty. That thing is going to be like my life project. In fact, I don't even know where it's at right this minute. That's my other whip. Here's your needles. Okay, so do you have anything coming up? Like what you plan on working on this week?
I'm going to work on the same three I've been working on. Nothing new.
I'm going to work on January, the celebration, year celebration that I've been working on. I'm trying to get that one done before January. Okay, so how about a haul?
Okay. My needles. And then I'm in Crazy Annie's Fabric of the Month. Picture This Plus.
Felix? Yeah. It's the. Can you see this?
It's a blue or a gray.
When I get close, it gets like dark gray. But it's actually more of a blue, almost like a real light slate.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's a pretty color.
And then Crazy Annie had this Miss Polly's Horn Book, and I believe you decoupage it.
Here's the picture.
And it goes on that little board right there.
And then you put it on the board. You make a really cute ornament.
Yeah.
It's kind of vintage looking. It'll go really nice on your tree.
Yes, it would.
Speaking of trees, if you guys are on Instagram, I definitely suggest going over to Lisa Stitch and Stable. She has the cutest Buffalo Check tree with little trucks on it. Her tree is super cute. So I'm going to go ahead and I'll put her name down below so that you guys can walk on over and check that out. I definitely highly recommend more trucks on her tree, but it's a super cute tree. Okay, what else you got?
I ordered this from True North Minders. I have a thing for scissors.
She does have a thing for scissors. I was helping her clean her scrap area and spare bedroom one time, and my husband and I took bets on how many scissors we were going to find. I don't recall the number, but it was massive.
I think it was like 50.
These ones are cute.
She also gave me some DMC in the mix also. And then I went to Best Buy. Merry Christmas to me. Merry Christmas to me. So we scrapbook. And we go to scrapbook retreats, and we like just to scrapbook what we've done while we're there.
I'm jealous of her Christmas to herself. I also have a sprocket, but she got a can of Ivy, and it prints in two sizes. I think I need one.
Maybe Santa Claus will bring you one.
And maybe if these scissors just keep walking this way, she won't notice. Okay, is that all for hauls?
That's all I have.
Okay, next, my haul. I found, I was at Hobby Lobby yesterday, so the Coming to Town Santa that we did as a sal with Snug Harbor, I am going to go ahead and paint this. I'm thinking white. Paint it a white, and then do the magnet trick that Mom was talking about where she did the magnets on her item and then put the washers on her stitching so that you can change it out. I think if I paint it white, I can change this out for the seasons. So it was at Hobby Lobby for $9.99, but they are 50% off right now for the Christmas sale. So $5.
Pretty good.
All right. And then my material. And then Mom got her ring back.
Woohoo!
I thought she was going to hurt somebody, but no more plastic ring for Mom. So yay. So moving on to things that I have laying around my house. My grandpa has made us a quilt frame. I have not went out to their house yet to bring it, so I can't show it. So stay tuned for our next floss tube. It will be featured. He made it, and I'm pretty jazzed to show it. Next thing, I did get off of my Christmas tree, my nanny, took my kids' hands when they were little, and she made me Christmas ornaments. So each one of these is from the kids' first Christmas. So I'll get a little closer. This is my older one. She did a little holly leaf on this one. I think she did that. Oh, no, she did a Christmas tree on my son's. And then my daughter, it's another little holly leaf stitch. So these reside on my Christmas tree every year. And then I take them off and I put them in a very special box because they do not go with just regular Christmas ornaments. That's something I have laying around my house. Next, we'll move on to the quilt of the week. So
this is another Thimbleberries that Casey and I did.
A while ago. This one's the block of the month.
Yes.
Yeah.
This is the block of the month. I believe I'm the one that quilted this one. I don't like to quilt on my quilting machine. It's out in the garage. During the summer, it's like 130 in my garage when it's 120 outside. And in the wintertime, we get down to 40s, 30s, 40s.
It's cold.
It's too cold. So I'd rather just send mine out.
And have them done.
And have them done.
Well, it was once a month we would get together with the ladies. They'd come on over and we would pre-cut their fabric. Yeah, you heard that right. We would stay and pre-cut each one of the 2x2 squares. Looking at this one right here reminds me of how much I dislike tiny squares. We'd cut it up, we'd label it, and baggie it for them. And so they would come and they could leave with a completed square, or they'd come and listen to whatever the new news was for the week, and then they could take it home, and it was pre-cut, ready to go. You'd have a square in less than an hour. And then by the end of the year, you have an entire quilt. We'll talk about the little red hats. This is Little Hats Big Hearts. They, every year, come February.
I believe it's in February. I believe it is.
They do a collection of red hat, little red hats or beanies for the babies that are born with heart defects. Thank goodness, and we have been blessed in our family. This does not touch us personally. However, who doesn't love to help out? So Mom has been working on the little red hats.
I have two done. Hopefully by February I have enough to hand out.
It says 8 in every 1,000 babies are born with heart defects. So we're raising awareness with these heart disease with the American Heart Association with the Little Hats Big Hearts program. So we'll go ahead and link that down below. If you guys would like to join in on making the little hats, that would be wonderful. And we will keep up the progress of where Mom's at with these little hats. Right. Do we got anything else?
No, I'm good.
All right. Well, on that note, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Bye.
Bye. I can't remember what...
They went to picture me perfect.
No, picture this plus.